I'm Alexander.
I'm Alexander too. It's a pleasure to meet you.
Pleasure to meet you too.
What brings you to this line of work today?
Well, jungle beats, baby. That's what makes it. That's what brings me. What about you?
True love. We're jungle beats. We're pretty cool, honestly.
And we're finally reviewing, reacting to Rich Brian, Rich Emmanuel, Rich Chigger.
Brian Emmanuel. Rich Emmanuel Brian. Brian the richest, Emmanuel highest above highest. Amen.
Amen. Bless.
Bless up.
I don't really have much to say. We've reviewed his singles, a couple of them.
We've done 18, which is on the album. We've done See Me, which I thought was real dope. I've grown to like that track more.
All right.
I think that's it.
We've got a 14-track album. Let's see what this young man has to offer.
Yeah, this man's 18.
It's going to be very interesting. Amen. Track one. Straight into it. Behind the mannequins, even though some are gonna be like, God damn, it's a lot of hits. Hit them with them, get them out of the hits. I'm thinking, will I put them out of the bitch? Of the suicide boys, kill them all, rest in peace. Step on the coin, the buzz that I miss. Talking about something that I never did. I talk to myself and all my seven tricks. They love to go down the wall. Some people from my school, they all turned out to be some weirdos. I don't need no education. And then that's my favorite teacher. Hey. Hey, tell the bitch that I really give a fuck about you. Tell the man that he got it for the eight. Ain't cool, making up for the competition I ain't do. But like yesterday, I worked at my mom's cafe. Let it grow like every day. It's my only social place. Do the shit for the people that look like me. So the girls can't see them and think of me. And not that kid that throw that fit. Can see they get straight A's all week. Well, that's it? Oh shit, oh.
Well, that was a...
That was a quick 2 minute bar for bar.
That's quite short.
I don't really hear what he was saying. I was really just caught up in the flow.
I was
caught up in
the flow and the sort of like jungle sort of feel I had to it. Like the drums was like poof, poof,
poof, poof. Yeah.
And then the bass kicked in the second verse. Amen.
I think it's a strong start to the album. I think it's a...
I think so as well. He's displaying what he can do.
Right. Be interesting to dive into what he's actually saying.
Come on, come on.
It reminds me of, I was trying to think, who does he remind me of? Of Duckworth. He reminds me of Duckworth when Duckworth raps fast. Recruits on the block, love skate high bands in the disc crunch socks. Ice cream and let me get a double
scoop too. Then I slide off and I load right a drop. What he can do with this flow with him, as he's been sort of known for at the start of the script.
Next track is Cold. I just had that one place, so it's by friends, but today I feel like doing this shit alone. Call the mic down when I wanna hear some whisper. Call the mic down, alcohol up in my system. So I'm tired of sipping on some latte. Only do shit if we do it my way. Everything gon' depend on what I say.
With the more instrumentation added to it, like kept building and building. It's kind of like at the start I thought, you know, like his flow was kind of like so-so and the beat was so-so, but as it kept building and building, I was getting more into it. Towards the end I was like, ooh, this is real cool.
I think lyrically is the strong point for me compared to the production. I didn't really feel the vibe or the production of the song compared to you. I felt like it didn't vibe with me. It's different though, it's different, it's very spacey. It's like ethereal, it's like it's weird.
I love it. And also, I'm not sure how much he produced, but I know that Rich Brian produced a lot of this album.
Yeah.
I know that a lot of people are saying that the production to them was more than Rich Chigger's speaking on this album.
Okay.
So that's what some people have been saying.
So give him more credit than he kind of deserves.
So I'm not sure. They're saying like his future producer is probably more likely.
Okay. Again, the fucking glittery.
Must be his type of production.
Is that a xylophone?
Yeah. This is how he raps a lot, and he doesn't switch it up. No, he doesn't switch it up.
So you're coming around now.
I'm coming around. I mean, I'm kind of getting his style now because, you know, he likes to lay his vocals with the verses.
Mm.
And every now and again, he'll just do like his verse.
It's like a lazy kind of hazy flow.
I mean, the beat was hot, but I didn't like the switch. I like the
window. Closer to me, baby.
I'm close to you.
No. Just.
I liked when the xylophone came in. I like that sort of beat.
You know, often we hear that.
Yeah, but then when it switched up to that more sort of eeriness, I didn't really like that too much. I thought that his vocals, voice was kind of boring. I liked his vocals more in the last two tracks. Even though this track still has similar vibes to both those tracks, I thought it wasn't as interesting here.
I have nothing more to add to that.
Cold, this motherfucker.
Introvert featuring Joji.
Ooh, what's up, boy? Papa Flacco.
The man.
Can I have a pizza, please?
Hey, Bowser.
Drive my car.
Yeah, I feel like it's very obvious what direction we're going in with the production right now.
Hey, friend. Wanna jump my car?
No. Fear? I haven't done enough drugs to fuck up my senses yet. That was so average. This production is just not getting me. This production's not capturing me. It's not engaging me. It's cohesive. But I'm really zoning out. But maybe that's not a bad thing. Maybe his intentions, well, let's just zone out to this one. What you think?
I really like this track. I thought the production was really well done. I liked the regression through it. I thought Joji's feature was nice. It wasn't too over the top.
I agree with that.
He just had hook, what's the word I'm looking for here?
Hooker mooker?
Hook duties. He just had hook duties. And he did it well. Definitely the weak point of here again, as we've heard with the last track, is Brian, his vocals. To me, his vocals just don't, like, when you hear him on tracks like That Stick and tracks like the first track, Amen, when we hear his like low gravelly layered voice over the top of a really hard hitting beat, it works. But with beats that are more slow, melodic, building like this, it doesn't work. In the last three tracks.
Not if you want to engage the listener.
Exactly. I feel like, because he's just still so young and finding, well, he may have found his sound here, but finding vocals that work with the sound that he likes, I don't think his vocals are working too well with this. Like, I like the way the beat, like I said, I like the beat, I like Joji's feature. I like Brian on here, I just don't like him enough to stay engaged.
Well, this might be interesting. We're getting, the next track's called Attention featuring Offset.
Sipping on it after dinner. You say you hang with the man. I see him when I'm in the mirror. Pull a mirror. And a day ain't even having got that bill. On your pill. Every day I just be sipping. Dimensions. I am a Martian. I am not from this dimension. All of this water dripping on my panties like I rinsed it. For your daughter, I won't test her back. She in this pinch. Drunk, put your shot. Bought my bitch to bed. Keep your tip. Pull that watch. Play. Ain't keeping this in. I'm playing drunk, bitch.
We back.
It's exactly what we voiced before.
And we back. Exactly.
When Brian's a production that's more hard-hitting, his voice sounds good over it. As stated here, one of the best tracks so far.
Yep, agreed. Agreed.
Offset's feature, nice.
Not bad.
Not bad. Not bad. Great, but not bad.
Exactly. Didn't overstay his welcome. Exactly. When Offset's verse came in, I don't know if you noticed that the thing in the background, I don't know what instrument it was, but it hit a little harder. It was exactly what I wanted. Picked up. There we go. All right, let's have a look.
A good track.
Glow. Brian. Ooh, we've heard this one, Glow Like That.
It's just reckless. Think about you every time I see your jaws. Yeah. I be on my major muscle shit. Make my heart just fucking sick. Even listen, flying on your own now. I was just thinking about you and it made me think of colors to the space. Getting back, hit your words, I need my fix. Pull up on you, honey.
That sounds very different to the version I've heard.
Was it? Okay.
Yeah, the version I heard, the one with the video, I don't know, this just sounds different. The guitar seems more prominent, or it sounds a bit more, it sounds less.
This is a subtle banger to me. This is like in between the last track and the rest of it. So it's, again, it's not really capturing me.
I just find, I feel maybe with the last few tracks he was layering his vocals too much on softer tracks like this, but this track he just really lets his voice sort of do a lot of different on here. I like the hook too. I feel the hook was really good. I don't know how I feel about it now though, because it sounds so different the first time I heard it, but I still like a lot about it. I like the guitar, I like the eeriness to it.
Now, this is just a second song. Acting like a hooligan, I swear I think I'm fucking losing. If somebody call me up and told me I don't need the president, I said okay, then I proceed to leave my friends and they'll be asking me no more. I just close my door, but then do not disarm. Don't you get too close, you know I'm an animal. Don't wanna do not lose control. No camera, every time I'm on your own.
But like the second or third best track?
The beat bangs. But
his delivery?
Yeah, it was too so-so.
Hmm.
I mean, I feel like the...
His delivery is so-so like in a lot of this though.
But I feel like it works well with a track like this. I can kind of get it. Mm-hmm. Especially right after sort of like Amigos feature as well with a track in between.
Mm-hmm.
But I feel like the first track we got, Amen, his flow was very different. He was flowing fast, he was flowing hard. But here he just sort of flowed one way.
Lazy.
I feel like if it was a bit more of an Amen intro track on this track here, it'd be a lot better. Still a good track.
I feel like you could apply that to most of this album.
Mm-hmm. It's goddamn tight. Hey, went to a baby club, shit has been a little girl. All my life, I only saw it on the beach until it said, I don't give a fuck about a motherfucking girl. On the beach, so I can't be smoking in the car. Flying 20 hours, never felt so right. They say I get better as the days go by. I just try to be the girl, used to see them.
Shit, if you about this boss, this looks trash. As the days go, oh, it's not trash. I was trying to be a girl. Like, you're not trash, but you're still something else. You're done. You're done.
Yeah, that's probably the worst track so far.
Really?
Yeah.
Just because the hook, right?
No, also the beat. I didn't like the beat either. That
wasn't the beat. Focus.
Mine was better. I know, I wasn't feeling that at all. Maybe if I listen to it again, listen to more of what it's saying, or just, I don't know. That didn't hit me very well.
I don't know, man. When delivery and vocals are very monotone at times, it's hard to really engage with what you're saying. So, like, I'm not even going to pay attention, really, to that, naturally.
Flights, more like... not a kite.
See me.
This track's good. See, I listen to this track a lot.
Yeah?
It's probably my top 10 most tracks this year that I've played.
Top 10 play tracks.
Yeah, play tracks. Would say like to have played, yeah. See me run into my love by you. Running for the fun, I feel like you seen it in this bitch. Pussy on my rock, the cookies are some side. Cause my bedroom is a side. Tell the girl that's my love, I take it on my life, girl.
Like, this is an example of a great, Rich Chiga track, because it's dynamic. Mm-hmm. It gives a lot of variety.
Exactly. Like, the beat's not as dynamic as some of the other beats we've heard. It's still, like,
but the flow switch-ups are.
Exactly. Like, he has a bridge, he has a hook, he has two different flows with the verses, actually probably has three. Like, he just mixes it up a lot more. Whereas some of the other tracks we've heard, the production will be a bit more progressive than this, but his flow will be very similar, so the whole way through.
Same.
So this is definitely a good example. Like, I even think as much as I like this beat could be better, which would even amplify this track even more.
Yeah, okay, that's a nice critique there. Mm-hmm. Even though we did like it quite a bit,
mm-hmm.
As you guys saw in our single reaction. Yeah, that's a great example of Rich Brian just doing a great track.
Mm-hmm. So thus far, enjoying the album, but just seeing so many ways it could be improved.
Yeah, next track, Enemies.
I got enemies.
Got a lot of enemies. Got a lot of people trying to drain me out this energy. Trying to take away from a. If it doesn't need to be said, like, I'm not just gonna say it. Like, I can say it, but I'm just gonna say it. You know what I'm saying? Like, I just don't need to always say it.
You're right, I could say it anytime I wanted, but I fucking won't.
Only when the windows rolled up. Okay,
you remind me of what I don't wanna be. We don't work, be the name in case you start an agency. My dad is a lawyer, he will tell me about his days of work. Now I'm trying to put on another frequency. On so many lists, but still pull up.
I feel like the production sometimes has an Asian style influence. You hear in the background?
I feel like it's had that influence all of the sound. It wasn't bad. But I don't know how I feel about it.
We're just getting more of the same, but different same.
Like, I don't know if I like the beat, if I was just content with it. I didn't know if I liked the flow, or if I was content with it. Is this all one of those tracks where it's just like, if I really paid attention, listen to it, if I listen to it like 10 times in a row, I'd probably like it.
No one listen to me! Damn it! Yeah!
Hey. I don't know the lyrics. I need pads in here.
But we said in the middle, we're seeing some Asian style influence in the production. I just wanted to mention that. We'll see if you guys have picked that up as well. Like, comment below, otherwise maybe that's just us.
Yeah, I've been hearing them all throughout the album, definitely. What we got
Kitty.
Next? That sounded like a siren though.
Yes.
It's called Kitty.
Kitty.
This is about my little kitty cat. His name is the...
Kitty.
Fuck me.
Let me tell a story about a boy named Brian. This is not a fairy tale. No, this not what I'm applying. This is really not the time where I'm writing about flexing. Not some bitches on the phone, but I'm really not replying. Type shit with a kid. If we done enough to get us up a trip to the first lane, nightmare. The better fucking sit. Fuck a little
bit.
Feeling like we ain't got time to think. Sick of this. Feeling like we be the kids. And that's when I finally met the boy.
Where you go?
No, that I play when it comes to getting that kid. You're the kid for my life. To the store just to buy your fucking mattress. If that could mean she gon' end up on my nitrous. Back to the story, now I'm talking to this girl. I'ma call her Tracy, and she looking like dessert. She cruising down the pole town, making sure I put the bitches round on upside down. Getting pretty wet, sweat running down the neck. Yeah, the kitty's so cute, I wanna keep it as a pet. She's a female, her pussy smell like honey. This is how funny, get her house, so you know what's better happen next. But the girl that did the D, even said her name. Then he asked if he could take a peek. Jumped out his fucking seat. Turns out I fucked his sis.
Wow.
That's fucking dope.
That was a cool track.
Well, that was great storytelling.
Yeah. It's one of the first tracks where we've actually been paying attention to the lyrics.
Right, because he was...
It was being really funny, which is definitely one thing. Maybe it's been funny in the previous tracks, but I just didn't pick it up.
Deliveries, but was great there.
Oh, yeah. And the way the bass kicked in back and forth. Just let his delivery sort of really carry through.
Was that a track about how he lost his virginity? It was, right?
I don't know. Was it?
It sounded like it. I mean, if you...
But then the end, he turned on the lights and it was his sister. Or like the chick's sister.
Well, he still lost his virginity to somebody.
Either way, that was a dope track. I like that. That was cool.
Little Prince featuring Nicki.
Okay.
Getting a bit poppy here.
No, I ain't about to chase it though. I'ma knock on wood and climb up hill. That I'm right, that I'm right. Go ahead and dream. Take some melatonin and go ahead and say. Point it at the target, shoot your shot. Walk out in 1, 2, 3. Know the same game that we play. Yeah, we play. This is dumb to listen. Goals already written. Fire in my soul. Can't hold no composure. I'm going on. It's my dream and ain't nobody finna wake me.
I'm sorry about before. That's actually the worst track right there. That's the worst track.
Is it because it's a poppiest?
Yeah, it doesn't suit him. The feature just sound like a straight rip off of Scissor.
But I mean, but she did a good job.
She did at
being
a
copycat at SZA. Like, okay, cool. She did, got nice vocals.
She was the best part of the track. I didn't like the beat. It was way too poppy for me.
But it went around in circles for me. Every time she came in, same hook, boom, boom, boom.
And, yeah, I felt like it was more hook than verse.
Yeah.
I just didn't like the track at all. It's really out of place in the album. Unless the next two tracks are like this, it's so out of place in the album. I didn't like it. The first track where I've been like, nah, I prefer Flight over that. And Flight I was iffy about.
Second last track, Chaos.
Short and sweet.
Definitely the most experimental production wise. Most experimental sonically.
I like the beat. I liked how it was short because I thought it was kind of. But it was weird because he switched his swaps towards the end, but it was so short that he went straight back to the hook.
Right. But that was nice though. I like that.
Yeah. So it wasn't. It was a very similar problem to a lot of the album this track had. It was the vocals didn't work well enough for me. It didn't. I don't know. I feel like more minimalistic bangers suit his. Like minimalistic production suits his voice more for bangers. It was alright. It was okay. It was better than last track, so it's gone for it.
Last track, Arizona featuring August 08.
Well, he's friends with September 07.
With and then it starts again. That's cool.
Anyway,
I think it was a nice way to end the album. August 08. I liked his vocals.
I thought it was really bad.
Really bad.
Really bad. I didn't like it at all.
Why is it really bad?
It just sounded so fake to me.
Okay.
It's like what the sort of tone he was going. And then when he said like fucking it, when he had the fucking in there, I was just like, ugh. It just ruined it for me. I did not like his feature.
What about Brian?
Rhyme was alright, but still, the hook was so bad to me that I barely liked it. But when the switch up came in, the switch up was dope. It was like an Odd Future sort of switch up. It was fucking sick. I love the way he ended it. I love that finishing bit. But the start with the feature, with September 07, fucking terrible.
And as an album, let's wrap it up.
Rich Brian. Amen.
This is a very average album.
It's a good start though. So I feel like a lot of this fan base is younger people.
Uh-huh.
And I feel like a lot of younger people will like this because the production has bangers. It has a lot of sort of his style of production as well. It also has a few softer and poppy stuff on there too. So it's got a little bit of everything.
Yeah, it's not cohesive as a project. I thought it would be, but because the bangers are spliced in there randomly. Yeah, this is not a special album. This is an average album, but he's young. You know, I'm going to give him whatever, man.
It's like when I listened to Jaden Smith when he was rapping at 16, I was like, this is trash. And my friend's like, hold up. He's 16. Right. Listen to it from that perspective. I'm like, this is pretty decent.
Like your frontal cortex doesn't stop developing until you're 25.
This man is from Indonesia. He got famous to begin with for doing a video that when he microwaved bread for 2 minutes. Do you remember that video?
No.
It was microwaving that. Bread. It was a video called How to Microwave Bread. That's the first thing I saw from him.
Yeah, the baby.
Yeah. So for someone his age to like go to America and do all of this, he's doing big things for his country and he's doing big things for himself.
Props to him.
There's a lot I liked about this album. There's certain tracks I liked. I liked more the more banger hitting tracks from him. There were still small, like, side ones like See Me and Glow Like That that I quite liked. So a lot to be desired. Like I leave this album being like, it's cool, I like a lot of it, but pretty much nearly every single track I was like, it could have improved this, it could have improved that. I feel like that's the story of the trick on this album. I keep just wanting to hear improvement.
Okay. And I finished this album with feeling like I liked a couple tracks and the rest of it I'm not going to go back to. And that is that. Jungle Beats. Rich Brian 18.
Rich Brian, Rich Jigger, Rich Emmanuel, Brian Jigger, Brian Emmanuel, Brian the Truth, Rich of the Truth, Brian, September 07, August 12th. Let's do it. We're out. Jungle Beats. No disrespect. I don't really need it if my life's gone wrong. What if I just die with that tonight? That's the bullshit, I'm dead. Skull emoji, nigga, I'm dead. Whatever, whatever.